As a designers, we love to prototype in Figma. But how we bring those animation to life? Well, I got something amazing to share with you today. Midface is a new free software and it's a game changer for UI UX designer looking to create stunning animations. With Face, you can easily export your animation with the formats as JSON, LOTI, MP4 and GIF. Super user friendly, and creating animation takes moments rather than hours compared to other softwares. You can import images, LOTI, SVG directly from Figma or other tools. That means you can take your existing designs and enhance them with animation seamlessly. The editor is really similar to Figma, so if you know how to use Figma, you will know how to use Face. Creating animations is really straightforward. By using automatic keyframes, the editor is taking all the heavy lifting and you can just focus on designing and creating animations. And just like Figma, you can collaborate on your animations. So in today's video, I'm gonna walk you through three quick animation tutorials. We will start by creating a burger menu, then we're gonna move into loading animation and finish off with the day and night toggles. So let's get started with our face animation. So we're gonna start by drawing a rectangle. So we're gonna select the rectangle tool and we're gonna give it rounded corners of 30. Then I'm gonna duplicate that rectangle but holding option on my keyboard, and we're gonna change it to black color. Next we're gonna go into animate mode. So you can see now we have a new panel, and if I start moving our elements, automatic keyframes gonna start showing on this panel. Similarly, if I wanna to rotate item, the keyframe will show up, or if I wanna change color, again, automatic keyframe is gonna show, and there is much more effects, but we're not gonna go too deep into this tutorial. We're gonna start by creating a simple burger menu. Next, because we're gonna change position of our rectangles and also we're gonna rotate it, I wanna lock those positions the rectangles are now by adding an event on current position on both our rectangles as well as the rotation. Next, I'm gonna move to 20 seconds, and now we're gonna move rectangles so they collapse together. So I'm gonna move the left and right rectangle. As you can see now, automatically the animation is created. Next, let's make sure we lock our rotation again, because in the next step we're gonna rotate on 45 degrees. So I'm gonna move now to 40 seconds, and I'm gonna rotate the left rectangle by 45 degrees and right by minus 45 degrees. Then we wanna hold that position for 20 seconds, so let's lock this again. And then on 1 second, we want our rectangles to go back to collapse position. So we're gonna change rotation to 0. And then after another 20 seconds, we want rectangle to go back to be a burger menu. So we're gonna change our Y position on both of rectangles. Now let's make sure all the steps have locked position as desired. And now our burger menu is ready. We can change the speed of animation by clicking this button. On export, we can select which format we want, as well as which speed we want, frame rate, start time, and end time. For the next animation, I'm gonna start by changing the screen size to 375 and 812, same as mobile, and I'm gonna change color to blue. We're gonna draw a circle in the middle where our loading animation gonna happen, and we're gonna type text loading. Next, I'm gonna draw a check mark by using a path tool. And let's make it slightly bigger, so I'm gonna change the borders to maybe 8 pixels and make it rounded. The next thing, I'm gonna duplicate our circle and we're gonna change it to be only border, and first one's gonna be filled one. So this border gonna be 4 pixels and we're gonna go for some light blue color. Next, I'm gonna duplicate the circle 2 more times and draw a rectangle on the left side by using union group. I'm gonna create only half a circle, so I'm gonna go for intersect, and I'm gonna do exactly the same for the other side. Next, I'm gonna select the path tool and draw 2 waves, and I'm gonna select our first circle and 2 waves, and I'm gonna close them into mask because I don't want those waves to go outside the circle. So now they are hidden inside our main circle, and we have 1 blue border and then 2 half white borders. Let's change the wave color to be 2 different shades of blue, and let's go to animation mode. In the animation mode, first thing I wanna do is to lock position of the waves. So similarly to previous one, we're gonna go to the position and lock that for both waves. On 20 seconds, I'm gonna slightly change their shape. Then after another 20 seconds, I'm gonna move the wave up again and change the shape to create a swimming move. I'm gonna repeat that a couple more times, and I'm gonna make sure the wave is covering the whole circle. On the last step, our wave, gonna cover the whole circle without the wave shape. And I'm gonna repeat that process for the second wave, exactly the same. Next thing we wanna do is we wanna hide the check at the beginning and show it only after the waves finish their animation. So on 0, we're gonna go to opacity and lock at 0%. Then at 80%, I'm gonna still lock it at 0, but at 82, I'm gonna change it to 100%. Next, we're gonna go to our half circle. So in the half circle, we're gonna go to effects and we're gonna select the trim path. On 0, I want this to start and end at 0%, and then at our 80 seconds, I want the animation to finish at 100%. And we're gonna do that for both left and right side, so it's creating this loading effect. Our loading animation is ready. For our day and night switches, we're gonna start by selecting rectangles and give it a rounded corner. Next, I'm gonna give it some light blue shade, and we're gonna add our switch by selecting the circle tool and change it color to white. Next, we wanna draw some mountains. So again, path tool, change color, and another mountain. And now we don't want our mountain to go outside the shape, so I'm gonna duplicate again the background, which is the main rectangle, and close all of that into mask. I'm gonna add a couple of stars by using the circle shape, and then I'm gonna close them all together in a group. So to animate, we're gonna start by animating our switch. So we're gonna lock position at 0, and then at 1 second our toggle will go to right, and after 2 seconds it will go back to the left, because we don't want the toggle to go just left and right. We want to go to right, hold there for a second, and then go back to left, hold there for a second, and repeat the process. We're gonna add a couple of steps in between to make it more smooth. So let's move our animation to 80 seconds, and we're gonna hold there for 40 seconds in that position, and then at 180 we're gonna go to the other side, hold there for 40 seconds and go back. To make it more smooth, you're gonna change the animation style to be ease in at the incoming animation and ease out at the outgoing animation. Then we wanna animate our background, so at beginning it's gonna be dark blue. We're gonna hold this background for a bit, we're gonna change it to light blue, and then hold light blue for a bit and change it back to the original blue. With the stars, we wanna create animation that they're showing up from the top. So we're gonna lock them position at the beginning, then we're gonna move them outside and then bring them back. As you can see, they're going out of our mask, so let's move inside the mask so we don't see the stars going up and down. Next, we're gonna move our mountains. So at 80 seconds, we're gonna move one mountain up to the right and change the color to green to create a grass effect. Hold there a bit and then go back to original state and color. The other mountain, we're gonna move the other side and change it to different shade of green. And we can also change the color of the switch to create a moon and sun effect. And that's it, our day and night animation is ready. If you wanna learn more about motion design, you can take a free course that is available on the Face community. I will find all the links below in the description section. And as always, if you have any comments, leave them down below. See you next one.